So welcome to my podcast.
This is what my 2050. So as this channel is mainly focusing on the data science, big data and automation technologies. Before going to the data science or machine learning, I want to actually want to state about what is data, that is the information, and how much the size versus quality matters, and when does the size matters. So, there, for example, Facebook or Amazon or YouTube, whatever may be the top branding websites, they are using like they are consuming zettabytes of data. More than that, they are consuming in their day-to-day activities. So, as we all know, for every seconds there are a huge amount of data that is being used from us. So that's what all people are calling as big data, where we involve with three kind of V, that is volume, velocity and variety. Today I am going to talk about the topic size versus quality. When does size matters? So as we are in the era of big data, it is sometimes surprising that smaller is better. Time and effort spent on random sampling not only reduce bias but also allow greater attention to data exploration and data quality. For example, missing data and outliers may contain the unusual information. It might be prohibitively expensive to track down missing values or evaluate the outliers in the millions of the records or the data, but doing so in a sample of several thousand records may be feasible. So, data plotting and manual inception lockdown if there is too much of data. As we all know, if there are like 1 MB of data, we can manage with the data through manual intervention through Excel or something like that. But if there are millions of records like zettabytes or petabytes of data, how can we deal with it? So, when our massive amounts of data are needed, the classic scenario for the value of big data is when the data is not only big but sparse as well. Consider the search queries received by the Google, where columns or terms, rows or individual search queries and cell values are either 0 or 1. So, depending upon whether a query contains a term, the goal is to determine the best predicted search destination for a given query. So there are over a trillion words in the English language and Google processes over 1 trillion queries per year. This yields a huge matrix, the vast majority of whose entries are zero. This is a very big true big data problem. Only when such enormous quantities of data are accumulated can effective search results be turned for most queries, as we all seeing in a Google in our day-to-day life. And the more data accumulates, the better the results. For popular search terms, this is not such a problem. Effective data can be found fairly quickly for the handful of extremely popular topics trending at a particular time. The real value of modern search technology lies in the ability to return detailed and useful results for a huge variety of search queries, including those that occur only with a frequency, say 1 trillion. Considering the phrase Ricky Ricardo and Little Red Riding Hood, in the early days of internet, this query would probably have returned results which has starred and children's story Little Red Riding Hood. Later now, the trillions of search query have been accumulated based upon that particular topic in which the Ricky narrates in a dramatic fashion. So keep in mind that the number of actual records, like the consistent records, ones in which this exact search query or something very similar appears together with the information on what link people ultimately clicked on. together with information on what link people ultimately clicked on. Might need only be in the thousands to be effective. So, however, many trillions of data points are needed in order to obtain these records. That is, random sampling, of course, will not help. So this is what I was trying to say. So, how people...